Google has their G-Tag, Facebook has their Pixel, and LinkedIn has their Insights Tag. Today, I'm going to show you how you can install this via Google Tag Manager onto your website. My name is Julian, and this is another episode of Measure School.
All right, welcome back to our demo shop where we want to install our LinkedIn tracking now. To do this, we need to have Google Tag Manager already set up. So this is the case on this page. We are in the preview mode, so Google Tag Manager is installed correctly, and you will need to have a LinkedIn account that you can connect to your ads. By the way, we also have a Measure School LinkedIn page that you can follow to stay up to date with what we do here. But inside of your LinkedIn account, you can go over to this work tab here, go to Advertise, and this will put you into the LinkedIn Campaign Manager. So here we have our demo shop account, which we have already set up. And we're going to go ahead and click on Account Assets up here to install our Insight tag. The first thing that you should do here is to add your domain. Now I've already done this, as you can see here. This is important, so we'll be able to later check if our tag is working correctly. Now let's go ahead and click on this Manage Insight tag to see our actual tag. And if you click on this first point here, I will install the tag myself, you get our code that needs to be deployed. Now all we need from this code is actually this number right here. So I'm going to copy this. Unfortunately, we can't copy the number, so I'm just going to go ahead and open up the developer tools here. We have our console. Just going to paste this in here just so I can copy out this number that we would need. Close this again and go over to Google Tag Manager. In order to install the Facebook Insight tag, we just go to New Tag, give this a proper name. And in the tag configurations, we already have a tag template available. Just search for it. And here we go, we have our LinkedIn Insight tag. And all we need to do is input the partner ID. Now there are some more settings here, but we can safely ignore them as we don't want to customize our tracking in any way. And all we need to do now is to deploy our tags on all pages. Now this LinkedIn Insights tag will provide us with information about page views. It will also let us retarget and do conversion tracking. So let's see if it works by refreshing our page in the preview and debug mode, going back to our page right here, and we can see our LinkedIn Insights tag already fired. Now there is no tag extension that we can install in order to see if LinkedIn is working correctly. So we need to trust our Google Tag Manager console down here that it deployed correctly. The ultimate test would obviously be inside of our LinkedIn Campaign Manager if we see that there would be a signal that was sent. Unfortunately, this takes a while, so I won't be able to test this right now, depending on your website traffic, as it says here, up to 24 hours. So you might want to check back later if there has been a signal received by LinkedIn. With that in place, we can go ahead and now deploy our tracking to all our website users by going to the Submit button, entering a version name, and publishing this to all our users so it goes live on our website. In this way, we have installed the LinkedIn Insight tag via Google Tag Manager onto our website. Now, what if you would like to install conversion tracking for your LinkedIn ads campaigns? This is also something that's possible. Let's go over here to Conversions, and we can create a conversion by entering our conversion name, for example, the thank you, the purchase of a product, let's call this purchase, and entering our settings, we choose a type here, for example, purchase, and we can estimate a conversion value that we want to enter. Now, unfortunately, we will not be able to port this over dynamically. So you could put an average value in here or nothing at all. If you don't want to put in a value, that's fine as well. You can then choose the attribution window. Select the campaign that you want to attach this to. I don't have a campaign set up right now. And then define whether you want to set this up through the Insight tag, which is already installed on our page, or want to deploy a specific pixel that fires when the user takes the specific action. If you go with the first option, it's pretty easy, but you can only track if somebody views a page. So for example here, we have an e-commerce store. So I'm just going to go through a conversion really quickly. And we get to our order receipt page. Somebody has bought something. So this is the URL that we could now utilize in order to tell our LinkedIn campaign manager that we want to count it as a conversion. So for example, we can choose different methods here, have the URLs that contain a specific text. In our case would be order received, because the other parts would change over time. So order received would be fine. And we can create a conversion. So every time a user clicks on an ad, then converts, gets to that page, it will be counted as a conversion. Now, if you want to be a little bit more specific and use the capabilities of Google Tag Manager, we can obviously also utilize the event-specific methods. So let's go ahead and set up a second conversion here, which will be, again, a purchase, which leave everything untouched. But this time, we want to install an event-specific pixel, and this will give us an image tag. Now, we're going to copy this. Just be aware that this image tag is specific to the conversion that we set up. So if you want to be in any kind of way dynamic, you won't be able to do this. This will only count a conversion for this one that we have set up right here. Now, what do we do with this code? In Google Tag Manager, we can go ahead and add a new tag. And this tag, this time, is not a LinkedIn Insights tag. And unfortunately, there's also no specific event-specific pixel that we can use for LinkedIn. So we'll go with the option of the custom image tag right here. And we simply enter the image URL. Now, we don't need this whole HTML that is around the actual URL of our image. So we're going to get rid of that, which starts right here after the source attribute. Let's get rid of that. And in the end, we also get rid of the HTML here. So this part would be our image URL that we want to fire when the user succeeds. If we wanted to recreate exactly what we have right here, we can look into our preview mode and we see there's a custom event here called gtm4wp.orderCompleted. This is custom to my website because I have set up the Google Tag Manager for WordPress plugin. And based off that, I can build a custom trigger. So I'm going to build a new trigger that will fire on a custom event, which is this gtm4wp.orderCompleted. Let me just see the exact event name right here. So I'm going to copy that. And as the trigger configurations, I'm going to choose the custom event. And here, I'm going to put in gtm4wp.orderCompleted. Now, this is just an example. It might be that you want to, for example, use a button click as a conversion goal or a form submit. Then you would obviously need to change this trigger around. Let's give this whole tag a name. This is still our LinkedIn tag. This time it's an event-specific tag for our purchase. Let's save this and refresh and go back to our page. Now we'll need to go through a conversion again. And here we go. We get to the order received page and we see our LinkedIn event purchase pixel has now fired. It's a custom image tag, and that sends the information over to LinkedIn. Again, you need to be patient here in order to see data showing up. Especially the conversion tracking only works when you actually have clicked on a LinkedIn ad and then went through and purchased the product. So that's the only reliable way to ensure that this is actually working correctly. So since we only can see this in our preview mode, we would actually need to deploy it to all our users by, again, submitting a new version, publishing this, and now it goes live on our website.
All right, so there you have it. This is how you can install the LinkedIn Ads Insights tag. I need to get used to the name still. Onto your website with the help of Google Tag Manager. It's such a pity that we aren't able to put in dynamic values such as our conversion value into this tag. So LinkedIn would actually pick that up and put it into our reporting. What do you think? Let me know in the comments down below. And as always, if you like this video, then why not give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to our channel right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.